at the Wright-Patterson Air Force Base Museum in Dayton, Ohio, and we're going to go check out some of the airplanes inside the museum. So I hope you follow it and check it out. Come on. Thanks. Hello, this is Mark back with you, and I am at the Wright-Patterson Air Force Base Museum, and we are in the first hangar, the early years. Like a display of engines, pretty cool. And that's awesome. The sucker's big. Didn't really look like there's a lot of people here today, but it's still kind of early. Here's an old one, 1912, with a Fiat engine. This is really cool. Cloth wings. Canvas wings, wood body there. Wow. Pretty cool. I like this. Here's the engine. And a little display there to read, pause it, you want to, check it out. And let's see, moving on. Let's see. Blower copies of Thaddeus Lowe's correspondence with the Union officials in 1861 and 2. Again, you can freeze frame it there, pause it and read it. You can zoom in and read it. It's pretty cool. Something that old is still around and on display. Version of an aerial map. Okay, let's see. Now here is an old display of the Wright brothers. One of their bicycles is on display here at the museum. Zoom in on that and you can read it. Yeah. Sprockets and some tools there. There's another plane from the early years, 1911, a Curtiss 1911 Model D. massive plane. Imagine setting out in front of one of them things. Okay, now we're back. Here's another old one. This is a Caproni from the Italian Air Force. It's pretty cool. World War One. 1914. Yeah. Long wingspan, man. And continuing on, we have a Martin from 1920, a twin engine. It's pretty cool. Big old sucker. You see that bomb on the bottom. open cockpit. Check this out. You can read it, pause it there. All right, cool. Okay, and continuing on here, we have a G3 target glider. The McCook Field Engineering Section developed a series of target gliders in the 20s, and this is when this is from. And it included the G3. Yep. Pretty cool. Okay. And here we have the P6E, starting in about 1925. Of the 8 different P6 models produced, the P6E remains the best known, and originally designated the Y1P22. The U.S. Army Air Corps redesignated the aircraft the P6E because of its similarity to the other P6s. Original P6E still in existence, and this P6E appears in the collars and markings of the airplane assigned to Captain Ross Hoyt, who was a commanding officer of the 17th Pursuit Squadron, 1st Pursuit Group, based in Selfridge Field, Michigan, 1933. And it's got a maximum airspeed of 204 miles an hour. Weighs about 3,432 pounds, 600 horsepower. There's the plane, there's the engine. Okay, we have here P-26A, pea shooter. The P-26A marked a significant step in evolution of the fighter aircraft. It became the U.S. Army Air Corps' first all-metal monoplane fighter in regular service. Maximum speed was 234 miles an hour and a range of 360 miles. Okay. All right, what we have here is the Ford Model T ambulance. There's the display placard talking about the ambulance. And again, you could pause the screen and read it there. Pretty cool. All right, and here we now have the Martin B10. Twin engine airplane. Check it out there. Again, like I said, you can pause the screen and read it. Pretty interesting reading. Pretty cool stuff. Here's a M16A2 multiple gun motor carrier. Couple gun turrets, four gun turrets in the back. Pretty cool. Here's a Sikorsky. Great big helicopter. Massive. Check that engine out. Sikorsky UH-19B. And you can pause that and read it if you wish. The lifeboat from the sky. EDO company developed that model lifeboat in 1947 to be deployed by B-29 bombers. There you go, something you can check out there. There's a B-29 fuselage that's painted, and looks like you can walk inside of it, so check it out. Definitely watch your head. Oh my gosh, here we go. Pretty cool, man, look at all that. Awesome. A lot of history right here. Wow.
through tunnel.
Wow.
It looks like a good 30 feet or so. There's the radio man chair. Probably that or the navigator. Navigator. Wow. Yep, there's where they have the bombs in the bay area. This is so neat. So neat. It's too bad we can't fly this now and drop it over there on the Russians. Give them a present from the past. B-29, cool. The Flying Fortress. Yeah. Looks like the Mosquitoes were used in Korea. The personnel of the 6147th Tactical Air Control Group, known as the Mosquitoes. It's so cool, man.
Attention visitors, please follow directional signs located throughout the museum. Signs are posted indicating lines for the Air Force Museum Theater and Museum Store.
Yeah. Display the ground crew, radio jeeps. And looks like we have here a FA-498 Starfire, I believe Lockheed. Pretty cool looking jet. Wow. Yeah, Lockheed. The F-94AA Starfire. There you go. An F twin Mustang. F-82G twin Mustang. Wow. That's wow. You ever see anything like that in your life? And the display, informational display there. Check that out. Yeah, very, very cool. Very cool indeed. Okay. And moving on, we have a F-4C Phantom II. Look, these were used in Vietnam. Well, start of Vietnam, Southeast Asia. Yep. And there's the placard you can read. Check it out. Okay, and here we have a MiG-21PF. Fishbed D. And it was used in Southeast Asia. continuing on, here is a Jeep, a communications Jeep. You can see the seat, one passenger is backwards. It operates the controls, radio controls. And of course the driver over there. Pulling the generator. The big aerial antennas. And the interesting read about the combat control team that operated the Jeep there for the communications. Check that out, pretty cool. Okay, and continuing on, another Sikorsky. It's a big one too. Used in the Vietnam era. The Sikorsky and the Jolly Green Giant. Yep. And there's this. You can check that out. Okay. Another helicopter. This one's a Bell UH-1P. They also nicknamed them a Huey. Also used in Vietnam. Okay, now we are at where I particularly wanted to come, the Presidential Gallery. Named after William Boeing. Okay, I'm continuing the tour here through part of this display of some space suits and aeronautical stuff and some more airplanes before we get to the presidential hangar, I guess. There's a big ass airplane there. Dang. Sweet. That is a sucker. Big old sucker, man. Wow. Well, it's a XB-70A Valkyrie Mach 3 Marvel. Wow. Amazing. Last flight was February 4th, 1969. That's so cool. So here's a Lockheed YF-12A. Mach 3 interceptor. Wow. This one's cool. That's weird looking. Northrop Tacit blue. Built in the early 80s. In great secrecy.
Wow.
No doubt. Here's the placard on it. There, you can read it there. Check it out. Here's the Bell Helicopter Textron XV-3, 1951 Joint U.S. Air Force, U.S. Army Initiative. The world's first successful vertical short takeoff and landing tilt rotor aircraft. Looks like there's just room for the one pilot there. Bell completed two XV-3s and began hover tests in 1955. The first XV-3 damaged beyond repair, but testing continued with the second aircraft. The Bell XV-3. This flying vehicle here looks like a spaceship. The Avro Canadian VZ9AV Avrocar. Here's the C-119J Flying Boxcar Fairchild Satellite Catcher. Large aircraft. And here's the placard on it. Check it out. This airplane is the Independence, and it was used by Harry Truman from 1947 to 1953. So, going in and checking it out. Here's the cockpit. It'd be awesome to fly this thing, get it up in the air and take off, and man, it'd be neat. Wow. That's so cool. Air navigator set here. Coming through, see where some of them sat. There's a bed. And perhaps some of the media sat here as well. And the galley. My favorite place, the kitchen. Yay! Yeah. Mexico. Independence. Awesome.
Hi. Here at the Air Force One now at the hangar in Wright-Patterson Air Force Base in Dayton, Ohio. And here is the presidential seal. It's familiar. And go check out Air Force One. Come on. Thank you.